Hello, machinist. I came here today to ask Shogo something. Let's see. Shogo is... Oh, he's eating something. What are you eating today?
Hello, Tomemaru. I'm eating potato stick. Actually, sweet potato stick. This is traditional food in Kochi in Japan. It's very tasty.
Oh, this make it hard to stop again. Stop it.
Oh, it's routine.
Huh, I'm getting used to stopping too.
By the way, what did Tomemaru do today?
Today, I came to ask you about everyone's favorite, Swarf.
Oh, Swarf is a very deep subject. It's a good one.
I grow through pride. Let's start with what is Swarf?
That's a good question to start with. Swarf and cutting chips refer to the powder chips that are produced when cutting. By the way, do Tomemaru remember the processing method called cutting?
It's a process of cutting and shaving a material, is it? What is turning or milling?
Yes, cutting and shaving produce chips, right? They are called removal process, and chips are produced when unnecessary part of material removed. For example, there are chips from drilling. This is chips from milling. They are all removal process, right? They are all variable chips.
What? So are there machine tools that don't produce chips?
Yes, they are. Or rather, even when a single machine, there are machines that perform some machining that produce chips, others that don't do. For example, a machining method called burnishing, in which a tool is attached to the lathe or multitasking machine we are manufactured, and the tool is pressed against the material to improve the surface roughness, has become popular. It does not emit chips.
Yes, I saw that all machine tools produce chips. You said earlier that Swarf has value, but I have the image that Swarf is unnecessary after cutting. So where is the value?
First of all, chips have monetary value. If you separate the chips by material, have a contractor take them back, you will get some of your money back. That's why many factories take care to keep track of material and chips so that they don't get mixed up. And one more thing, chip tells the whole story.
What's that? That's slightly exciting word. I'd like to hear them.
Actually, you can guess how the machining process is going by looking at the state of chips. Let's take a look at this diagram. This chart shows the relationship between chip color and cutting temperature for steel-based materials. There are such a wide variety of colors. You can see that as it turns blue, the cutting temperature is also getting higher. Here comes by my chip collection. This is actual chip from the 6mm depth of cutting at Max Kanazawa Exhibition Hall. What does that mean?
That means it could have been at least 500 degrees Celsius or higher?
That's right. It was heavy-duty cutting and there are machining without coolant.
I didn't realize we could even get that.
There's more. Chips are a treasure house of information. Next, let's look at the length and shape. Here we go. This is a chart summarize the length and shape. Tomemaru, which of these do you think is a problem chip?
Anyway, long one don't look so good. Do you mean that one and two are chip that we should avoid?
That's why long chip can get entangled in workpiece or tool, or even cause the machine stops. So we want to avoid them.
Oh, the shorter the better?
It's true that you want to keep it short to certain level. But if the chip are too short for the commanded feed, as in 5, for example, you may have to pay attention to it. When chattering vibration occurs, chips tend to be extremely short and distorted due to vibration.
So you are saying that you should be careful about chips that are too short. Oh, it's really deep topic. For example, what should we do when long chips tend to be generated?
The general solution is to apply high pressure coolant, use a chip breaker, or adjust the machining conditions. Also recently, that one is famous. Do you understand Tomemaru?
The reverse question that came and been tested. Let's see, is oscillation cutting or something like that?
Yes, that's right, Tomemaru. You are getting more familiar with it these days. Oscillation cutting is a technology created an air cut area and break up chips by creating special toolpaths that oscillation cutting edge. Here are the chips. This is a chip, it's all so long. It can be cut into such small pieces.
Wow, it can be this small. It's more amazing than I thought. How do you actually use it? Can I do it too?
Yes, you can. Recently, a setting screen dedicated to oscillation cutting has been created. And if you enter the frequency and amplitude, it will judge whether or not the chips will cut under these conditions. In fact, if you adjust the frequency, you can even control the length of chip to certain extent.
I had never heard. You can even change the length of chips. When I demonstrated it at the exhibition, quite a few people came to see it, and I guess people were troubled by chips.
That's right, but actually we are finding other uses for Swarf these days.
Since they are so beautiful, can they be used for accessories?
Some people are making very cute keychains by putting chips in resin. There are more and more chips being posted on social networking sites, and more people are posting beautiful and interesting chips. From an operator point of view, chip used to be treated like an enemy of machining. But I think the SNS social networking service has changed the view that chips themselves can be a topic for posting. It's a content.
I have also come to like Swarf. I want to know more about Swarf. Collect the Swarf and make Swarf collection.
I want to see your Swarf collection. Does everyone else like Swarf too? Thank you for watching today. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and give us high rating. See you, machinists. Bye.